A dangerous cocktail of hot, dry and windy conditions has authorities on edge. Tonight, as 50 bushfires burn across the state, police are taking no chances. A strike force targeting potential bushfire arson with a warning the penalties are severe. Nine reporter Lizzie Pearl is at Telegraph Point, northwest of Port Macquarie this evening. Lizzie, the strike force is already treating 16 fires as suspicious.
It is, Pete. Strike Force Toronto has more than 50 suspected firebugs in their sights, and a specialist team of bushfire and arson police officers will be spread out across the fire grounds, across the state's hotspots as conditions start to get worse again tomorrow. Right now, 6,000 kilometres of firefront is burning across New South Wales, posing a danger to lives, homes and wildlife.
Emerging from burning bushland, this tiny fire victim west of Wauchope. Scared and confused, he ran into the fire, which had jumped the Oxley Highway. A certain casualty, if it wasn't for Tony Doherty, a grandmother of seven who put her own safety aside, following him in.
He just went straight into the flames, and I jumped out of the car and ran towards him.
Using a shirt from her back and bottles of water to douse the koala, his fur on fire. They bundled him in a doona heading for Port Macquarie Hospital. Today, a reunion of a rescue that's gone global.
You're a legend. Yes. Give us a hug. Oh,
thank you.
Tony, welcomed in by medical staff, back with the little man she's named Lewis, after one of her grandkids.
Good boy. We really hope you feel better.
Lewis is badly burnt. Overnight, he was given a lot of fluids, his paws carefully wrapped in bandages, and today he managed to have a munch on some eucalyptus leaves. Tony says she didn't think twice when she saw him in trouble.
Just natural instinct. I knew if we didn't get him down from the tree, then he would have been up there in amongst the flames.
Lewis is being cared for by Shane and the team at the Koala Hospital. Their wards are full of fire victims, bandaged and battered. Lewis, she says, has fared the worst.
He's got really badly burnt hands and feet. He's got burns under his arms. His nose is burnt.
And for those koalas which aren't badly burned or killed in these bushfires, survival isn't guaranteed. Already, the fires have claimed one third of the koala habitat here in the Port Macquarie region alone.
Thanks to Tony, Lewis is one of the luckiest, unlucky ones.
Proud as.
Yeah.
She's great.
She's pretty tough.
She's tough, all right.
The woman's a legend. Just a legend. No other word for it.
She certainly is.
And there's a chance the little guy is too badly burnt to go back into the wild, so he may join the breeding program where there's a mate ready to meet him. Lizzie Pearl, Nine News.
The Channel 9 bushfire appeal has now raised more than $1 million for those affected by the fires. If you'd like to donate, please visit bushfireappeal.com.au or call 13 18 12, and you can visit any Vinnie's store as well.